What's up, guys? How are y'all doing today? Today, I want to talk about the Model X range increase that's actually going to be going on the 2021 models. Let's talk all about it. And before we get started, like this video, subscribe if you haven't already, as like really helps out the channel. And let's begin. So the Model X range right now, as it states on the website, is 351 miles, which is basically class leading. It's the top of the class in SUVs. It's literally the longest range SUV you can buy in the world, electric SUV you can buy in the world today. Now, with this newer update that's coming out, apparently all these models should be getting it, the range will increase to 371 miles, which is about a 30 mile increase. I don't think there was something special that occurred with the Model X just recently. I think this was a gradual improvement that Tesla has done. Remember, a while back, the Model S range was about 370 miles, and then they bumped it up to about 390, and then Elon said on the earnings call that the EPA left the door open and that drained some battery overnight, and because of that, the range is actually lower than it actually is. So they redid the test, the EPA, and they got a range of 402 miles on the Model S. Now you take that same difference, apply it to the Model X, and that's basically where you get your efficiency from. So I'm pretty sure the EPA didn't test the Model X during that time period, and that's probably why the range has been relatively stagnant for a while. And now, pretty much suddenly, we're getting a massive range increase of, well, 30 miles. And wait a second. Okay, I don't know why, I'm just drinking coffee right here, but like, this is kind of like the morning. I said 30 miles of range increase. It's not 30, 371 versus 351. That's only a 20 mile range increase. So I don't know, I probably got confused with the Model X, the S. And that's probably why I said 30, but yeah. Hope you get the point. I'm not actually stupid. Did I blow my cover? I don't know. So yeah, hope you get the point. It's actually 20 miles, not 30. I don't know why I said that. So yeah, continuing on. Obviously, you can argue, well, that's almost 400 miles on an SUV using the same battery pack that they had beforehand. It's like, well, yeah. And the fact that this is an SUV getting almost 400 miles of range on one charge, where basically that was the range of the Model S less than a year ago. This is quite impressive. I'm not gonna lie. This is actually something very impressive that Tesla has been able to accomplish. But I don't think this has been due to any recent changes of the Model X. I'm pretty sure it's just been a gradual increase of efficiencies and just manufacturing and the way they introduce stuff just over time. And the EPA just tested it now and they're like, oh wow, we got the range of 371 miles. I was gonna say 51. And so that makes it an even longer range Model X. By the way, just a few years ago, I think about a couple of years ago, the Model S, using the same 100 kilowatt hour battery pack, had a range of 335 miles. That was during the time the Model 3 came out, and the Model 3 at the time had a range of about 310, now it has a range of about 320. Tesla has been able to do so much with just a 100 kilowatt hour battery pack and improve the efficiencies by a lot. I mean, think about it, you basically got 70 more miles of range using the same battery pack and just by motor efficiencies and other efficiencies involved with it, likely with software and the hardware combined. And that's what you get with the vertical integration, because you're making the software and the hardware, so the motors and the actual controllers for the motors and whatever the software that's actually controlling how the power is being delivered. You can really tweak that to a point where this car, or just any car, can have a pretty big range increase. And this is just great news for basically the EV industry. This separates the Model X from the Model Y. The Model Y is much cheaper, but for example, if you have the same range, around 330 miles for the Model X, which was the case about a few years ago, a couple years ago maybe, then there wouldn't be that much of a difference if you bought the Model Y or the Model X. But now Tesla is differentiating between the flagship vehicles, so the Model S and X, versus the 3 and Y, the more cheaper, more affordable vehicles for the mass market. And this just goes to show how well Tesla can actually improve if they get on something. Getting 70 more miles out of any battery pack of any size at the time is like a very big achievement. And these aren't long ranges. It's not like you're getting 800 miles of charge and now you're getting 870. It's not like a smaller percentage. This is a pretty big percentage range increase over time using the same battery pack. If I were to say which cars would get this, I would likely be very wrong. But obviously, if you buy a new Model X today, which actually the delivery time it says is 5 to 9 weeks, likely because they're shipping them to Europe and overseas and such, because that's what Tesla actually does. In the beginning of the quarter, they always produce all the cars for overseas, and then they ship them there. And then by the end of the quarter, those cars actually reach and get delivered. So basically, whatever cars they produce basically get delivered, or as many cars as they produce, the most maximum amount of cars actually get delivered to customers, just to get their numbers up, which is obviously a smart move by Tesla, because otherwise they would have like 200,000 cars produced in the quarter and only like 100,000 delivered, which you don't want that. So like I was saying, the newer cars definitely have the range increase. So if you buy one new today, you definitely have the range increase. You have 371 miles, which is actually very impressive considering you even have the 250 kilowatt charging. Obviously, it won't be 1,000 miles an hour of charging as it is in the Model 3 and Y, because this is just a more thirsty vehicle. It just consumes more energy, but it'll still be a lot. 100 kilowatts for this? Holy, that is very impressive. And I just think that some older cars, for example, a few months old, will also get this update, maybe in a software or something like that. So I don't know, maybe you can tell me. If you have a Model X, let me know in the comments down below if you got in a software update that increased your range up to, say, close to this figure. Maybe you have a previous model and the range went up from, say, 330 miles to 350. I don't know. Let me know what happens if there's an update, because right now, kind of clueless on this. All right, so before I end here, I just want to talk about the Model S and how it might impact the Model S. Well, I think that if this range increase is actually due to some other reasons rather than all the changes that have happened in the past, like with the Model S, just carried over to the Model X, if there are new changes, maybe software improvements, I do feel like the range on a Model S will definitely increase. So the percentage increase is about just under 6%. You apply that to the Model S, you get a range of just over 425 miles. I don't know if Tesla is actually going to do this, but just for the jokes and whatever sakes, why not, if the range does increase by such and such amount, why not keep the range of the Model S and just underreport it slightly, just to get the magical number of 420 miles on one charge? Do I think Tesla will do this? Honestly, I have no clue. I hope they do, because it's only a 5 mile drop, as if in 400 miles you're actually gonna feel the 5 mile drop anyways. But you know, it can just show that on the car that it's actually 425, but then you can charge it up to, I don't know how they're gonna do it, but whatever. They'll probably figure it out, and hopefully they would, because that would be hilarious to have a Model S, their flagship vehicle, have their top of the line range of 420 miles. That's just Illuminati confirmed at this point, okay? That, rest assured. So thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed this one, and let me know in the comments down below what you guys think, and are you excited for a 420 mile range Model S? So thank you again, and I'll talk to you next time. Peace.